Hey everyone, my name is Lynn Schrader and I empower men and women to step outside of their self-imposed comfort zone and start to do things they could have never imagined they could get done. I love to work on mindset with people and ignite a passion and a fire in people to do things that they've never done before and to make a change. Today, I want to talk to you about making small shifts that can lead to massive impact in your life. Let me tell you where this all came from. Two things happened in the last 2 days. Yesterday, I was on the phone with a business coach and sharing my goals, my dreams, what I wanted to accomplish, and all the things going through my head. And she was able to stop and have me make some shifts to produce a greater impact. And I'm super excited because sometimes we forget that little bitty shifts can make big changes. And I get to turn around now and help this with people, use the same information and help people in my business. Second thing that happened is I was, every Wednesday I get together with other moms from my son's high school, and we were talking today and we ended our morning discussing that how if we would all begin to make these subtle changes in the things that we've learned, how we could create a massive impact in the world. And you and I know that it's the little rudder in a boat that can steer this giant boat. A little rudder can do a lot of work. And that's the same thing that can happen for you and I. When we make little shifts in our behavior, our business, our personal life, our relationships, we can create some really awesome things. So before I get started, I'd love to know, where are you watching at? Put it in the comment section below. What city, what state, what country are you watching in? I'd love to get to know you a little bit and find out where you're tuning in from. If you're watching this live, write live. If you're watching this on replay, write replay. Now, on to the subject. So I'm gonna break it into three parts. Small changes in your business, small changes in your personal life, and small changes in your relationships, and what shifts in your thinking and what they can accomplish. In your business, instead of chasing every shiny object out there, the shiny object syndrome, and let's face it, those shiny objects are shiny for a reason. They look good. Instead of chasing the shiny objects, if we make a small shift and say, it's not time to chase that object yet, but we get a better vision on what we want to accomplish. Maybe write the one or two or three things that you have to get finished, you really want to accomplish this year, this quarter, this month. So making a shift of chasing the little shiny object to vision and prioritizing can make a massive impact. And if you've ever experienced that, give me a thumbs up. There are so many things that are out there in this day and age that all it takes is one little search on the internet and we decide we can do that. We want that. That will make our business grow even better. But if we continue to do that, we get nowhere fast. So change, make a shift from the shiny object syndrome to a vision mentality. The second thing is, instead of thinking you have to be all or nothing, I'm in this all or nothing, shift that to breaking it down. What's best for now? When I get done with these things, then I can go on. So instead of all or nothing, start to write the top five things that you have to get, that you want to do to chase that vision. Another thing is, if you shift from being regretful about everything into accepting where you are, you will see a massive impact take place. Because when we live in regret, we are not extending grace to us, and it makes us feel stuck. or it makes us feel like we're losers. But if we accept where we're at, maybe we stumbled a little bit, if we accept that all lessons are worthy, then it will make a big impact, because then we don't want to quit. We know we pick ourselves back up and we keep moving on. I know in my business, this is very common. People want to quit because they think they should have or would have or could have. They have this regret when really they just need to accept where they're at and continue moving. And the last thing for the small shift in your business is, when you are stuck, instead of feeling like you're stuck and you're not going anywhere, make the small move, just one tiny little movement. Get your toes wet, continue moving, and it will make a massive impact. When you're stuck, nothing happens, right? Nothing happens. You're paralyzed. So if you change that into making one little step in the direction where you need to go, one phone call, one reach out, one follow up, one more meeting, that is one step, and it's so much better than being paralyzed. Now, moving on to making shifts in our personal life and how that can make a huge impact. Instead of being envious or jealous of people, be curious instead. Instead of being envious, do a little curiosity challenge on yourself. You know that successful people leave a trail. They've done things in their life that you and I can follow, just like Hansel and Gretel, when they leave the little candy or whatever it was, the crackers, I don't even know what it was, breadcrumbs, that's what it was. They left clues. Successful people leave clues for us. So instead of being envious or jealous, shift your mindset into being curious, and you will have a massive impact, because envy and jealousy don't look good on you and they don't look good on me. The second thing, to begin thinking about studying and learning about yourself, reframe studying and learning as a must in your life instead of a maybe. I am a lifelong learner, and I believe everybody should be that way. We are continually adding chapters to the books of our life. We're continually growing. And it's important that we stay up with that. We become lifelong learners of us. So when you shift from thinking about learning as an option to learning about yourself is a must, you will see huge, massive impacts. Be a student of yourself. Education is your currency. Educating yourself about yourself is your currency, and it's huge. Another shift that we can do in our personal life is shift from saying, I'll try, to I will. I don't know how long it's going to take me, but I will. I did a video on here not too long ago about burning your ships so that you could take the island. Burn your ship so you don't have another excuse to say, I'm not going to fight this fight. When you shift from I'll try to I will, I don't know how long it's going to take me, you will see massive impacts in your life. Another shift, another mindset is to shift from this is a waste of time to every moment counts. If you shift from realizing that your life is not a waste of time, your day is not a waste of time. It might have felt like it, but I guarantee you there are life lessons that happened to you today. But you have to ask yourself, what were they? What can I take from that? An exercise that I like to do, I don't always do it, but I do try to do it, is when I'm in bed, ask myself, okay, what happened today? What were those lessons that were out there? Who came into my life? How was I able to speak into somebody else's life? Begin to think of your life as not a waste of time. Your day is not a waste of time, but it's an every moment counts time. The next one is, instead of being determined to win the race, be okay with finishing the race. Now, I'm not saying it's not great to win the race, because it is, but so many people think, if I can't do all of this, I don't want to do any of it. I love to go to the gym, and I'm so encouraged and inspired by people who look like they're sort of struggling in the gym. And in my eyes, I'm thinking, awesome, you are in the gym. You're in the gym. That is a great thing. So extend grace to yourself and not feel like you have to win the race, but stay in the race. Shift, and you will see a massive impact. The next one is, see mistakes. Switch from seeing mistakes as mistakes and see them as lessons. Great losses are great lessons. Great losses are great lessons. And if your kids haven't experienced, or you haven't let your kids experience losses and letdowns, then you're doing a disservice, because that's what life is made up of, a series of ups and downs and bruises. So when you shift from thinking, when you call a mistake a lesson, that's a huge shift. Now let me end this video by saying, when we shift, when we do little shifts in relationships, can be huge. And one of the shifts can be when you begin making eye contact with people instead of treating them as an afterthought or that they're invisible. Have you ever done this or experienced this? Because I've done both. Have you ever been in a crowd when you're talking to somebody and you know they're looking over your shoulder for someone else to come in, and as soon as that person comes in, they're like, okay, I see, I gotta go. I've been in that situation, and unfortunately, I've done that too. So when we begin shifting from thinking about people as afterthoughts or nuisances or invisible, and thinking about them as, I want to give them eye contact, I want to give them my all, what an awesome, massive impact you and I could make. So, another thing is, instead of being held captive by technology, constantly being on our phone, and I'm guilty of this too, instead of doing that, what if we stopped and engaged with people, really listened with our ear and our whole face, and got to know them? What a shift that would be in your relationships. It would be massive. The next one is, instead of judging, or I'm right, you're wrong, I'm not listening, I've always believed this, instead of doing that, why don't we shift and listen and hear people, hear their side of the story, let them hear our side of the story, and know that there doesn't have to be a winner. And the last thing is, instead of feeling like you're better, I'm better than that person, what if we realized that it's an even playing field? No one is better than another person. No one is higher on the ladder than the other person. We don't know their backstory. They don't know my backstory. We all have skeletons in our closet, right? We do. So listen, when you want an massive change, a shift in your business, in your personal life, or in your relationships, revisit this video. Go through some of those things. Stop chasing the shiny object. Stop thinking it has to be all or nothing. Stop living with regret in your business. Stop staying stuck. Stop being envious and look at people with curiosity. Be a lifelong learner. Know that every moment counts. Know that you don't always have to win the race, but finishing the race is an awesome thing. Revisit some of these things, and I promise you, your life will begin to shift, and a shift in a great way. If you got any value out of this, do me a favor, tag somebody that you think needs to listen to this. I love to pay it forward. What I talk about on here, I've learned from other sources and things like that. So share this, tag somebody. Thank you so much for watching, and I appreciate you. And I'll be back on here in a few days like I always am, and have a great afternoon.